गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल माई डियर स्टैंडर्ड 10 स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम बैक टू द ज्योग्राफी लेक्चर. चिल्ड्रन, इन माई प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव लर्न नेचुरल वेजिटेशन ऑफ ब्राज़ील एंड द वाइल्ड लाइफ ऑफ ब्राज़ील. टूडे इन दिस वीडियो आई विल बी टीचिंग यू नेचुरल वेजिटेशन एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ ऑफ इंडिया. लेट्स हैव अ लुक, लेट्स सी natural vegetation of India. Children, here you can see there are total 5 types of forest. Number 1, evergreen forest. Number 2, deciduous forest. 3, thorny shrubs. 4, coastal forest. And the last, Himalayan forest. Children, look at the map of major forest types of India. Here you can see the index, and always remember, whenever you are studying the map, you have to see the index properly before studying the map. Here, dark green color shown evergreen forest, light green deciduous forest, light green which is also called as sea green, which is called as that for thorny shrubs, neon color for Himalayan forest, and bluish green color coastal forest. So you can see here a darkened green color in the western ghat, and on the northeastern ranges they shows evergreen forest, and the light green color is the deciduous forest. So you can see deciduous forest occupy maximum area since it is receiving 1000 millimeter to 2000 millimeter of rainfall. Children, you can see here a neon color which is a Himalayan mountain. Here also you can observe it is Arunachal Pradesh, and the light green color here you can see that is a thorny shrubs, and the coastal forest also you can here see which is there in the eastern coastal regions of India. I hope you understand the major forest types of India. Let's see evergreen forest. Region which receive more than 2000 millimeter of rainfall and ample weight of sunlight, evergreen forest are found. Trees here are tall, dense and green. The leaves are broad and green. The trees' wood are hard and durable. Various types of creepers and shrubs grow at the ground level. That is, these creepers, they take the support of the tree and grow on it. Highest biodiversity found in the forest. Evergreen forests are found in Western Ghat, Northeastern region and Andaman and Nicobar Island. Children, let's see the trees found in evergreen forest, that is mahogany, rosewood and rubber. The same trees we have seen in the equatorial forest in Brazil. Let's see deciduous forest. Children, deciduous means the trees shed their leaves each year. Region receiving rainfall between 1000 millimeter to 2000 millimeter, deciduous forests are found. They shed their leaves in summer and regrow in monsoon. So they are also called as monsoon forest. They are found in the region of West Bengal, Chhattisgarh, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Jharkhand, Western Ghat, Maharashtra, Karnataka and Kerala. Trees found over here are teak, bamboo, banyan, sandalwood, etc. Let's have a glance. Teak, which is very useful for making furniture. Bamboo, you know it is useful for construction. Sandalwood, children, it's a very costly and expensive tree. It is used for making soap and also for perfume. We have banyan tree also. Thorny shrubs. Regions receiving less than 500 millimeter of rainfall and experiencing dry climate have thorny shrubs types of vegetation. The leaves are small in size. Example, catechu, acacia, kajari, bore, and varieties of cactus like aloe vera and agave. It is found in southeast parts of Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, etc. Children, let us look at these shrubs: acacia, bore, catechu, kajari, and aloe vera. Coastal forest. Coastal vegetations are found in swampy areas, estuaries, and lagoons, which has saline soil and moist climate. They are called mangroves or sundarbans in India. Children, as you all know, Sundarbans is the largest mangrove forest in the world. The wood of these trees are oily, light, and durable. Coastal vegetation is mainly found along the eastern coast. Children, let us look at the coastal forest. We have mangroves. Mangroves protect us from tsunami and also from high tide. They are very important part of the ecosystem. Lagoons. Lagoons is a stretch of salt water and separated by a coral reef or by other barriers. Let's see estuaries. Estuary is a tidal mouth of a large river for the tide majesty, or also we can see the river water meet the sea water. We can find aquatic plants, fishes and birds over here. Himalayan forest. Children, you can see the white color portion is cold desert. The green color down is the Himalayan forest. The climate is very cold in high altitude. Altitude means height. As altitude increases, temperature decreases. The temperature drops to minus 40 degrees Celsius in Jammu and Kashmir and the parts of Himalayas. It is snow covered in most part of the year. Very few species of plants can survive in such extreme condition. Only seasonal flowering trees are found in high altitude, so the vegetation is very scarce here, means less here. Himalayan forest starts from Jammu and Kashmir to Purvanchal mountain in the extreme east of India. Let us see the types of forest in Indian Himalaya according to altitude. Highest altitude, we have medium altitude, and the last, foothills. In highest altitude, seasonally flowering trees are found. In the medium altitude, we can observe coniferous trees like pine, deodar, fir, etc. In the foothills, we can see mixed forest, both coniferous and deciduous. Example, sal. Children, let's see the vegetations. We have pine, deodar, fir, sal tree, and also one more flowering plants which you can see in higher quantity. Children, India is the 12th mega diverse country in the world. According to Indian States Forestry Board, the forest area of India is 21.34%. forest is interrelationship between life and environment. So children, conservation of forest is a vital important for the survival and prosperity of mankind. Now let's see wildlife. Forests are the home of variety of wildlife. There are varieties of reptiles, amphibians, mammals, birds, insects and worms. India is a mega diverse country in terms of wildlife. There are many species of wildlife found in India. Children, let us have a look. Elephant are found in hot and humid forest of India, especially in Kerala and Karnataka. One-horned rhinoceros are found in the swampy and marshy land of Assam. Wild ass and camel are found in the arid land, that is in the desert area of Rajasthan, which is called as Great Indian Desert, and run of Kutch in Gujarat. Snow leopard and yak are found in the snow-capped region of Himalayas. Peninsular regions, we can find the Great Indian Bison, deer, monkey, antelope and snake. India is the only country in the world where both lions and tigers are found. Gir forest in Gujarat are the home of the Asiatic lion. Tigers are our national animal, is found in various parts of a country. Coastal areas, rivers and estuaries, we can find turtle, gharials and crocodile. A variety of birds are found in the forest of wetlands. Children, let us see the birds. From the left side is kingfisher. Just below that, white color, is the crane. Third one is a great Indian bustard, peacock, duck, pheasant, pigeon and parrots. All these species make our land a unique habitat of wildlife. Children, you know, many species of wildlife are on the verge of extinction in India because of hunting, pollution, deforestation. We can see some of the animals which are on the verge of extinction. First is the lion, till macaw. Second is the Nilgiri tahar, black buck, which is also called as an antelope, and cheetah. The government of India has set up number of national park, wildlife sanctuaries. Tiger is a national animal of India, is decreasing day by day. Similarly, the number of elephants are also decreasing. The government has established Project Tiger and Project Elephant to protect these animals. Children, here we completed chapter number 5, Natural Vegetation and Wildlife of India and Brazil. I hope you understood the chapter properly. Thank you, students. Have a nice day.